Hi, welcome to John's Gallery. Come on in. This is some of the earlier works. This is a Journey in a World of Prismatics, and actually one of my oldest paintings. I haven't here right now, but this whole wall consists of my older piece. That's in 73. I started in 72. This painting over here is City of Lights, and it was done in 94. But it's been pretty well liked by people on the internet. And it has the geometric patterns you can see from over here. It's kind of a special little guy called The Energy from Beyond. And it's also one of my older paintings. It was done in 73. A very special painting because when Comet Geotech was coming through, I did this painting about a week before, so something was going on there somewhere. Got also some Picasso effects, which I love. This is Metropolis. It's a great painting. I love it. It has pieces overlaid on top of the others, you can see. And once you take the knife and do an area, then you go back over and do it again, and you never really lose that impression that's underneath there, which is really great. But this painting came out. I mean, either it works or it doesn't work. There's no in between. This guy, I love this one. It's called Grease Quilt. And I love the pattern because they're so soft in color and whatever. I mean, it's like a shadow on there. It's almost impossible to duplicate something like that. But it happened one time, and that's the way it is. This painting is called Tiffany's Window. As you can see, it's a big window. I love stained glass. I had to do a piece, and I did it this large, and enjoyed every minute bit of it that I did. This is a stained glass piece. As you can see, I love stained glass. I love the way the light comes through the window. And my main object in painting is purely light, to bring the light into the work so that the light looks like it's coming through the painting. And in this case, it does. And that's what I work on more than anything. This is a geometric pattern here that I've been working on. And it's kind of like a quilt pattern, but not particularly. But just overlaying the paint, then going back over again to bring out these colors. And it's the same thing here, same technique, but there are pieces of layered on top of it, and that's how we get this effect in here. And the same way with this here, with the pieces and objects on top of other objects. So like laying pieces of paper on there, I guess, in a sense, but it's all done with a knife. Same way in this one over here, which is a little more dominant in color. And this now is my special gem series. I love this, called Black Opal, and it's one of my favorites. And I love the way the gems are, and I love the way the light works in with this here also. It's called Blue Diamond. As you can see, it looks like a big diamond. And I love it because it reflects the light that I love, and it just comes right out at you. One of my paintings, although we're done 79. And of course another geometric one over here. And I did some little dark areas in here which bring out a little more of the painting. But it's always trying this and trying something else. You always want to keep working back and forth. And you never make any mistakes. It's impossible. This is another geometric one here, more of a quilt pattern, which I've done a lot of, but it's a learning process in what you do. So you just keep working at it. And then you go on from there, I guess. The painting is called Embryo, and as you can see, it's alive. I mean, you can actually feel movement in this painting. And it was one of those crazy things that you do, but when it happens, it happens, and I love it. It's got energy there. In fact, there was a gal was saying she loved to have that hanging over the bed because of the energy in it, and then getting up in the morning, she'd be full of energy. And I think, well, that's pretty fantastic. This painting is kind of a newer series that I've been doing, but I worked to color in and get the color all brought out. And then what I would do, I would move it into the other and move across. And then you kind of get this wispy stuff in here, which I love. I love Whistler's work, and his work leaves something to the imagination, which I love. And this one is similar in some ways, I feel, to Whistler's painting, rocket painting that he did. And I love it because it's got the energy there and the colors and whatever else. So it's kind of a new series I've been doing, but I love it. And then again, you've got this one over here. Same kind of a situation where the color is run into the other and then runs back through. And it's kind of take a chance where you do it, but life's a chance anyway, isn't it? And same with this one, I love this one. Look at this. I mean, the color is just unbelievable. The way things are running into each other. And it's so muted. The same way here. I call this one heaven and earth, and it's like this is earth and whatever, but it's got energy in there that's unbelievable. And the same with these guys right here. I love this painting also. I was almost going to scrap it at one time, but once you get into the painting, it's a little bit different. So it's not all face value. You've got to get into the painting and get beyond it sometimes, which a lot of people do.